This module of the Environmental and Historic Preservation webinar series will discuss the National Environmental Policy Act, or NEPA, and FEMA Region 3's compliance with this law. My name is Leigh Hagan, and I'm an Environmental Protection Specialist in the FEMA Region 3 office in Philadelphia. And today I will be presenting the NEPA module. NEPA was one of the first major environmental laws passed in the United States when it was signed on January 1, 1970. The stated intent of NEPA is to ensure safe, healthful, productive, and aesthetically and culturally pleasing surroundings. To meet that intent, NEPA establishes a national policy for the protection and maintenance of the environment by providing a process that all federal agencies must follow. As part of this process, NEPA requires federal agencies to give equal consideration to environmental factors, in addition to financial and technical factors, in their planning and decision-making. NEPA directs federal agencies to consider environmental impacts prior to undertaking any major federal action. The Council on Environmental Quality, or CEQ, which was established by NEPA, oversees the administration of NEPA and provides guidance and implementing regulations to federal agencies for NEPA compliance. These CEQ NEPA regulations can be found at 40 CFR parts 1500 to 1508. Each federal agency is also required to develop NEPA implementing procedures that supplement the CEQ NEPA regulations. The FEMA-specific procedures are detailed in a FEMA directive and a companion instruction, as noted on this slide. In 2020, CEQ made wholesale revisions to the NEPA regulations for the first time in more than 40 years. These recent updates to NEPA regulations address timing, procedures, and content of NEPA reviews. However, pursuant to Executive Order 13990, which was issued in January 2021, CEQ started a comprehensive review of the NEPA regulations issued in 2020 and announced a phased approach to amending the regulations. As mentioned previously, the overarching purpose of NEPA is to promote the enhancement of the environment through evaluation of the environmental impacts of federal actions. As part of that, NEPA is meant to act as a decision-making process, but it does not mandate a specific outcome. This procedural process of NEPA provides a unified framework to help federal agencies coordinate review of an action and ensure it is compliant with various environmental laws and executive orders. And within this framework, an agency such as FEMA can determine the necessary level of NEPA review and environmental planning that each action requires. Another major purpose of NEPA is to provide information to the general public on major federal actions. As such, the NEPA process requires agencies to disclose information regarding the environmental consequences of their actions. NEPA has several specific goals to meet its purpose. The NEPA procedures require federal agencies, such as FEMA, to conduct a review process that integrates consideration of the potential effects of proposed actions and alternatives on the human environment, which typically includes physical resources, such as geology, soils, air and water, biological resources such as plants and animals, cultural resources such as archaeological and historic resources, and social resources such as communities and economics. As part of the NEPA procedures, development and analysis of potential alternatives to the proposed action are required to ensure a robust decision-making process. Reasonable alternatives include all feasible and practical actions from a technical and economic standpoint. And last but not least, another goal of NEPA is to ensure agencies provide an opportunity for public involvement in the process of evaluating alternatives and potential impacts. NEPA is triggered by federal involvement. It directs federal agencies to consider environmental impacts prior to undertaking any major federal action, which includes direct federal agency activities, as well as provision of funding, assistance, or approvals by federal agencies. This means that NEPA does not apply to non-federal actions such as state, local, and private projects if there's no federal involvement. However, If these projects are funded by FEMA, then they would be subject to the procedural requirements of NEPA review. Also, it should be noted that even if NEPA does not apply, other environmental and historic preservation laws may still apply, and the project will need to comply with them. NEPA compliance begins with identifying the proposed action. The full scope of an action must be clearly defined prior to determining the appropriate level of NEPA review and assessing the proposed action's impacts. In order to analyze impacts of a proposed action and alternatives, FEMA must collect information on the potentially affected resources. Additionally, public involvement is one of the most important steps in the NEPA process. Therefore, FEMA must make the information available to the public, and the NEPA process provides various opportunities for public outreach, notification, involvement, and consultation with external parties. As appropriate, FEMA will engage the public, tribes, minority and low-income populations, and other external parties during the NEPA process. Because NEPA provides a project planning framework, the NEPA regulations encourage integration of the NEPA process with planning and reviews needed to comply with other environmental laws, regulations, and executive orders. As such, NEPA is considered an umbrella law in that other more specific environmental laws can be reviewed under or during the NEPA process. Any research, planning, and consultation required under the other laws is often conducted concurrently with and incorporated into the NEPA process for a more streamlined review. Although NEPA does provide a framework for considering other environmental and historic preservation requirements, they may not all be fully addressed solely because NEPA is completed. In this case, some compliance activities may still be underway after the completion of FEMA's NEPA review. Compliance with the requirements of other environmental and historic preservation laws applies to projects regardless of the level of NEPA review, including those projects that are statutorily excluded from NEPA, which will be discussed later in this module. As mentioned, NEPA applies to a wide range of federal actions. Because different actions have different effects on the environment, there are differing levels of review under NEPA. For each of its actions, FEMA must determine a suitable approach to NEPA compliance given the nature of the action and its setting. The four levels of NEPA review are listed on this slide and will be discussed in more detail in the following slides. The level of review and associated documentation is determined by the degree of environmental impacts, except for statutory exclusions, which are certain actions that are exempt from NEPA. Most FEMA-funded projects fall under either a statutory exclusion or a categorical exclusion. A statutory exclusion, or STATEX, is for certain FEMA emergency or disaster response actions that are statutorily excluded from NEPA review by the Stafford Act. STATEXs apply only to FEMA public assistance and individual assistance projects. It should be noted that the use of a STATEX does not mean other federal laws, regulations, and executive orders can be ignored. FEMA must still ensure compliance with these and address them as needed in the project review. Examples of FEMA-funded projects in which STATEXs are used include emergency protective measures, debris collection and disposal, in-kind repair projects that return facilities to pre-disaster condition, and sheltering projects. A categorical exclusion, or CATEX, is a form of NEPA compliance that applies to specific types or categories of actions that do not need to undergo detailed environmental analysis because it has been determined through agency experience to generally have no significant environmental or historic impacts. The categories of actions range from administrative actions like training and exercises or development of engineering plans to more involved actions such as facility improvements, infrastructure projects, or even limited work in streams. CATEXs often include disturbance limits and restrictions on what is and is not allowed. Three criteria must be met to use a CATEX. One, the entire action must clearly fit a CATEX. Two, the action must not be part of a larger connected action. And three, there must not be any extraordinary circumstances present that require more detailed NEPA review. Extraordinary circumstances refer to circumstances that make an action or alternative unusual and could include greater scope, size, or potential for degradation in an area that has existing poor environmental conditions. If extraordinary circumstances exist, an action that is normally able to be CATEXed may require an environmental assessment. Examples of commonly used CATEXes are those for facility repair back to pre-disaster condition, acquisition demolition projects, and completion of studies and surveys of a minimally intrusive nature, such as engineering, modeling, or an H&H study. Similar to a STATEX, FEMA must still ensure compliance with other laws when using a CATEX. An environmental assessment, or EA, is prepared when an action is not eligible for a CATEX, and it is unlikely or unknown whether the action could cause significant environmental effects. An EA can be prepared by FEMA staff or by a non-federal representative, such as an applicant or their contractor, with consent by FEMA and if FEMA participates in the preparation process. An EA describes and analyzes potential impacts of the environment of a proposed action and at least one alternative, and provides an opportunity for public involvement and input in the decision process. An EA must provide sufficient information to determine whether an action would have significant environmental effects that may require an EIS. Examples of FEMA-funded projects that may require an EA are listed on this slide and include new construction and relocation of utilities or facilities. An EA must include several minimum components, including a purpose and need statement, description of the proposed action and alternatives, description of environmental impacts of the proposed action and alternatives, as well as the affected environment for impacted resources, and a record of agencies and persons consulted or coordinated with. Other contents that should be included in an EA are a title page, description of proposed mitigation if applicable, and references. Another critical part of an EA is public involvement, including the opportunity for public comment and input. An EA must be made publicly available for review and comment during a comment period that is typically 30 days long. This normally occurs at the draft EA stage by providing a notice of availability of the EA and notification of methods of public comment. The outcome of an EA is either a finding of no significant impact, also known as a FONSI, which is prepared if the action would have no significant effects on the human environment, or if the action would have significant effects, a determination that an environmental impact statement, or EIS, will be required. At that point, a notice of intent announcing an agency's intent to prepare an EIS would be prepared. This graphic shows the general workflow of an EA within FEMA. This process expands on the general NEPA compliance process discussed earlier and highlights the important steps of the public comment period and the issuance of a FONSI, or proceeding to preparation of an EIS if applicable. And lastly, an environmental impact statement, or EIS, is the highest level of review under NEPA and is required for federal actions that would have significant environmental impacts. FEMA actions rarely require EISs. The outcome of an EIS is usually a record of decision, or ROD, which is a decision document that provides an explanation of the reasons for selecting a particular action and environmental mitigation associated with that action. Thank you for watching the NEPA module of the Environmental Historic Preservation webinar series. This slide provides resources from FEMA and the Council on Environmental Quality that may help you learn more about NEPA.